activists claim that dozens were killed in the Syrian city of Homs yesterday. It's a battle that shows no sign of abating, certainly not if the rebel group, the Free Syrian Army, get the weapons that they're looking for. Yarabu Malam has been covering the rise of the Syrian opposition since last year. In recent weeks, she has gained extraordinary access as they gather the funds to buy the weapons they need, all under the leadership of a former human rights lawyer. Lawyers, guns and money, all in her Fly on the Wall report.
Cairo's Tahrir Square is again echoing with freedom's call. This time for Syria. Just across the city, a building which is a hub of Syrian opposition activity in Cairo. I've come to meet Haitham Al Maleh, a leading opposition figure now in exile. He's someone that Syrian leader Bashar al-Assad probably wishes he had never let out of prison. The building is a work in progress, much like the opposition's plans to oust the Assad regime. Al-Maleh tours the world, lobbying for action on Syria.
They're all the people that you've met on this trip, or in Cairo in general?
General. Visitors.
I'm preparing myself to be the new president of Syria. Do you think I will be or not?
The 81-year-old was Syria's first human rights lawyer.
I feel pain inside myself when I see the woman, children killed by the army of the Syrian regime or by intelligence service or by Shabiha. Sometimes I cry myself. I cannot see the picture on the TV sometimes, because it is so hard. For that, I ask God to protect me.
Driving past the Adra prison just outside Damascus, it's where most of the... I first reported on Haitham Al Maleh just weeks before the uprising in Syria began. He was jailed for a third time by the Assad government over his comments in a media interview. In these rare images of the interior of the Syrian military court, the 80-year-old is under heavy guard. Al Maleh is granted a few moments to comfort his wife. It's their last embrace before he's yet again sent behind bars. Since being released last May, Haitham savours his freedom. But his opposition to the regime in Damascus comes with a heavy price.
I feel that I'm in a dangerous situation, but I don't care for that. The Syrian regime sent some people, some hunting people, to kill the opposition. Not only in Cairo, everywhere. I am number one in the killing bill.
You're on a hit list.
Yeah.
His office is downstairs, where the meetings, phone calls and media interviews never stop.
Hello. Marhaba, Rio. Hello.
He's just announced his resignation from the Syrian National Council, the main political opposition group, saying they're undemocratic.
They do not want to work as a really democracy situation. They want to keep everything for themselves, the bureau of the council. So I found myself must leave.
And now he's created his own group, its sole purpose, to arm the rebel Free Syrian Army.
And in the end, to finish the Syrian regime.
And he wants to raise $1 million.
Why do you need $1 million?
I want to buy weapons to send to Syria.
Where do you think you're going to get $1 million from?
From some Syrian people.
Where do you buy the weapons from when you get these donations?
This is not a good question from media because it's secret. I get weapons from everywhere.
You don't seem like the
We have several sources. One of the sources inside Syria, from the regime, from the army.
Al Maleh has already been funding some of the rebel fighters, and they've sent him this thank you from the front.
You're a lawyer.
Yes.
You're a human rights lawyer, but now you're arming the revolutionaries.
The time is changed. I'm a lawyer in Damascus, in Syria. Now I'm out, and I'm working for support the revolution. And now only the way good to finish this the regime in Syria is to support the free army.
Getting money is one thing, but using it to buy guns is another. Haytham's German bank won't release his funds to Egypt. He's making a trip to his local bank to sort the matter out.
They refuse to do it because the Syrian problem, they want to know what I will do by this money. We have no way, no political way to finish this problem in Syria, and the only way to finish this regime is by force to fight.
So how did it go inside?
Huh?
How did it go?
It's good, yeah.
You getting your money back?
No. I sent a letter to Minister of Foreign Affairs in Germany to give me back my account. So this is the game now.
Ya Allah! Ya Allah! Tahmi Syria! Ya Allah!
Ya Allah! Tahmi Syria! Ya Allah!
Ya Allah! Tahmi Hama! Ya Allah!
But there's no money problems at this gathering, a fundraiser on the anniversary of the Syrian uprising. When the distinguished guest takes the stage, he lashes out at the ruling Assad family in Damascus by describing a conversation with a government minister.
هذا النظام أتقن الخداع والكذب. سألني حينما جاء بشار الأسد إلى الحكم ما هو رأيك ببشار الأسد؟ قلت هل تجد الأفعى إلا أفعى مثلها؟ كيف يمكن أن يكون بشار أسد خلاف أبيه؟
الشعب يريد دعم الجيش الحر. الشعب يريد.
And then the money begins to flow.
5,000. Assad and his family, they will face the same end of Al-Qaddafi. Because the blood invites blood.
What do you want?
For myself, I want to arrest them all, put them in jail and start investigating them.
Back in the office, these men have turned up saying they represent a rebel group and want funding. But in this murky world of arms dealing and spies, Haitham must tread very carefully. This is Zuhair Siddiq, a man who gave false testimony accusing Syria of killing the late Lebanese Prime Minister Rafiq Hariri. The killers are still at large despite an international investigation. Haitham is immediately suspicious. The meeting is going badly and Siddiq starts getting edgy about my camera. The talk turns to Haitham's network that supplies the rebel Syrian fighters.
إسرائيل خلاص
صح
ما بعرف
بس شكرا
انت بتعرف
شكرا لك صح
اهلا وسهلا
والله خليك تضحك صح
شو هالحكي يا كتر خيرك والله
صح لخليك تضحك
عم تهدد
قدام الكل عم هددك
ايه تهددني
ايه
ايوه اهلا وسهلا
اي نعم واحيانا تسمع شيء ما شفته يا هيثم المالح وانا زهير الصديق لا تسمع شيء ما شفته وانا عم
Al-Maleh is taking a break in his apartment. With reports of abuses committed by rebel forces and after what's happened downstairs, I'm keen to know how he decides who can be trusted with his money.
I know from the people who connect inside Syria.
I mean, it's quite hard to define who the Free Syrian Army is. Is there some sort of order, some sort of hierarchy?
No connect between all, because there's several groups inside Syria. We are trying to create one union Syria Free Army.
Later, he receives more visitors seeking money. Rebel envoys have arrived from the battered city of Homs. They're discussing how to smuggle weapons into the country. Al-Maleh has never met them before. And it's not until late that evening that enough checks have been made to sit down and talk specifics. I'm allowed to film as long as I don't show the face of the envoy. It's a rare insight into the Syrian uprising. After the greetings, the talk turns to weapons.
يعني أي نقطة حدودية في
سوريا
هل امتداد الحدود؟
نعم العملية عم نخطط لها نحن في شيء
بمليون شمال دولار
بمليون دولار في عملية كبيرة يعني
الله ما
قد تؤدي إسقاط النظام
إن شاء الله
They discuss how they'll run the country if the uprising succeeds.
هلا نطلب تشكيل مجالس مدن ينبثق منها مجلس وطني من الداخل حصرا وينبثق منه حكومة انتقالية برئاسة الأستاذ حسام المالح
شلون بيشكلوا هذا السؤال مهم في إمكانية
في إمكانية
إذا قدروا يشكلوا فعلا مجالس مدن عمان هي يعني تضبط العمل في الداخل لأنه بيهمني كثير عدم الفلتان الفلتان بيخوفني كثير
أكيد
It's now very late, but the night isn't over for Haitham. He's ducking away for a TV interview.
How does it feel to always be on the run?
What can I do?
This time he's appearing in a special Al Jazeera discussion. He knows that as well as funding the rebels, it's critical to keep publicising their cause.
النظام لا يهمه شيء ولا لا يردعه دين ولا خلق ولا قانون هو منفلت نظام منفلت من عقاله أساسا أنا دائما أقول سوريا دولة خارج القانون وأنا أعني هذا الكلام بمعنى نظام فلتان مجرم يعني
عصب
يا
عصب هو بتكلم الأستاذ هيثم دائما ما عصبت لكن أحيانا برفع صوتي
ترفع صوتك
هذا دليل يعني حتى أجسامي حركة
We've reached the early hours of the morning and the strain of the last few days is beginning to show.
العجوز ختيار هذا يضل بيشتغل ما بيوقف امبارح الساعة واحدة انا نمت الساعة واحدة فقت مالي قادر فيه متعب
But the next day, Haitham has mustered the energy to continue his campaign. He's off to Germany, Poland, and Vienna with an equally hectic schedule.
And you're not tired of this? I mean, this has been almost like a lifelong mission for you.
No, I don't get tired because I want to finish my job. I want to finish this regime. After that, I will retire.
It's amazing they let her film some of those scenes, but I'm glad they did. Yara Boumelham with the 81-year-old would-be president. Yara has written a blog for our website about the task ahead for Syria's opposition. There's also a photo montage of some of the most memorable images from the past year in Syria. That's at sbs.com.au/dateline. Coming up, Hong Kong's dirty laundry on display.
They shouldn't have the right to stay in Hong Kong because they just work in Hong Kong.
They say you can work here, but you can't stay for good.